Did you know that according to research, 75% of dogs don't get enough vitamin D? Now, if that's true, that could really put your dog at risk for cancer, kidney, heart, and immune diseases. But before you reach for the vitamin D pills, I wanna tell you why it might just be a waste of money. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. Now, vitamin D isn't technically a vitamin. It's a hormone that's produced by the kidneys. In you and I, 90% of our vitamin D is made when our skin is exposed to UV light or sunshine. That's why vitamin D is called the sunshine vitamin, even though it's not a vitamin. Now, receptors in the skin convert cholesterol into vitamin D. And you can also get vitamin D from your food or from supplements if you take them. But your dog is different than you are. Dogs like Eli here can't make a large amount of vitamin D from sunshine, and that means they have to get all of their vitamin D from their food. Now, there's two types of vitamin D that your dog can eat. There's D2 and D3. D2 comes from plants and mushrooms, while D3 comes from animal sources. Now, dogs can use both kinds of vitamin D just fine, but cats can really only use D3. Now, when your dog eats vitamin D, it's an inactive form, and then it gets stored in his fat cells, and it just sits there until your dog needs it. And then when he does, this vitamin D precursor travels to the liver and then the kidneys, where it's converted to the active form of vitamin D, which is called calcitriol. This is the form of vitamin D that your dog can actually use to boost his immune health. So now that you understand just a bit more about vitamin D, I want to talk about the research that says most dogs don't have enough of it. Now, back in 2016, there was a study showing that vitamin D levels were lower in dogs with cancer than those without cancer. And they found that vitamin D levels varied a lot and related to how much vitamin D the dogs ate. Now, this 2015 study lumped 320 dogs into three categories. They either had enough vitamin D, not enough vitamin D, or really, really low levels of vitamin D. And they said that most of the dogs didn't have enough vitamin D. But like the cancer study, there was a really wide range of vitamin D levels in the dogs eating the very same foods. If you look at the minimum and maximum amounts of vitamin D in the dogs eating the same foods there, there's a pretty significant difference in their vitamin D levels. Now, the researchers concluded the dogs should get more vitamin D in their diet, but that doesn't make a whole lot of sense because it's pretty clear that vitamin D status isn't really all that related to what the dog eats. Besides that, vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin, which means that if you give your dog too much of it, it can build up to dangerous levels and cause serious kidney damage and even death. And you can see that if just giving your dog more vitamin D-rich foods worked, you wouldn't see so much variability in dogs eating the exact same foods. So why are researchers having trouble proving that eating more vitamin D will actually boost your dog's vitamin D levels? Well, it turns out they're measuring the wrong thing. They weren't measuring the active form of vitamin D that dogs can actually use. They were just measuring the precursor form. Now, remember, the vitamin D precursor needs to be converted in the liver and then in the kidneys before your dog can use it. And the same thing was happening in human studies. They were just measuring the precursor, not the active form of vitamin D. So, this is where it all gets really interesting. And by the way, if you like this video, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the next one. If you don't subscribe, Eli's going to be really sad about that. Now, recently, researchers at the University of California, San Diego, did something really unique. They actually measured the active vitamin D, not the precursor. And what they found is that vitamin D levels are linked very closely to gut bacteria diversity. Now, this shouldn't come as a surprise because we already know that the gut bacteria produce other vitamins like vitamins K and a lot of B vitamins. So here's how it works. Your dog stores the vitamin D that he eats in an inactive form. Now, in order to actually use that vitamin D, he needs to first convert it into calcitriol, which is the active form of vitamin D. Now, this conversion is linked to the number of friendly bacteria that he has in his gut. These are the bacteria that produce a short-chain fatty acid called butyrate. And this helps protect the gut lining. And it turns out that these friendly bacteria also turn on enzymes that help convert the vitamin D precursor into active vitamin D. So what this means is that your dog's active vitamin D levels aren't linked to how much he gets in the diet or how much vitamin D supplement he gets. It's linked to how well he can convert vitamin D precursor into active vitamin D. And that's linked to how healthy his gut is. Now, the researchers even concluded that it seems like it doesn't matter how much vitamin D you get through sunlight or supplementation, nor how much your body can store. It matters how well your body is able to metabolize that into active vitamin D. So, is it true that most dogs are lacking vitamin D? Well, we actually have no way of knowing that because they're measuring the wrong form of vitamin D. But the danger in assuming that dogs do need more vitamin D is that it puts them at risk for vitamin D toxicity. In fact, dog foods are recalled all the time for excess vitamin D. So it's really risky to give your dog vitamin D supplements on top of what he gets in his food. Plus, we know that it doesn't really raise his vitamin D status all that well. More is not always better, and it looks like you need to focus on how well your dog can convert vitamin D, not how much he gets in his diet. And how do we do that? Well, you focus on your dog's gut health for sure. And here's five quick ways to do it. First, reduce your dog's EMF exposure. That means keeping him away from cell phones and Wi-Fi devices as much as you can. Second, feed him more fruit and veggies. They contain polyphenols, which are important foods that feed the friendly bacteria species that make butyrate. Polyphenols only come from plants, not from meat, and heating and cooking can really destroy them. So get some fruits and veggies into your dogs. Third, avoid any unnecessary antibiotics and drugs. They'll kill off a large number of your dog's friendly gut bacteria, and you don't want that. Never feed your dog foods with oats or legumes like peas, lentils, and beans unless they're organic. These foods contain more glyphosate and other pesticides than any other food, and they destroy friendly gut bacteria. Finally, give your dog probiotics. This will bolster friendly gut bacteria populations that produce butyrate. My favorite is soil-based probiotics like Bacillus subtilis. They're much more likely to survive your dog's harsh gut environment than regular probiotics because soil-based probiotics can form a protective shell. Now, do you have a question or comment? Let me know below. Have a topic you want to talk about? Leave a comment below. And if you liked this content, please like and share it. Thanks for watching.